Welcome to Start Building Me, my nightly training session, because exercise is mandatory, like eating, sleeping, going to work, going to school, breathing. If you do not exercise your body, or how do I phrase it normally? If you don't work your body won't work. Sad but true, folks. People squirm, they cringe, they try and think of so many different reasons why they can't exercise. No time is the most painful one that I hear. Out of 24 hours a day, they can't find 15 to 30 minutes to improve their mental and physical well-being. Well, I doubt that. I doubt that seriously. So I'm just fiddling around with my sound, waiting for people to rock up. No rush, and I'm going to train anyway. That's why I do this, folks, because I do this anyway. Every night before I kick back to break up the work that I've done during the day, whether it's trading or working in the garage on my project car or dirt bike, I want to break up the day, break up the rhythm, want to earn my dinner, and just be able to, you know, slap myself on the back and say, hey, cool, you did a training session. It doesn't have to be the gym. Something, you know, I don't really like going to the gym that much. It's everything that I can do here. I have to go to the gym, I have to do something that I can't do here, which is normally heavy bag for boxing or something to that effect. So here now, doing bodyweight squats, doing push-ups, as I explain every night, and I'll explain it every night until the day I die, how to do it properly, how to improve, and how to monitor your performance over time. That's what we're trying to do, folks. Once you start seeing that trend occur, you will start being motivated more. You will start to form that healthy habit by seeing the metrics, by seeing your performance increase over time. Without that trend line monitoring, so without any feedback, it's not that common that people will stick with their habit or their exercise program. So that's the foundations of athleticism, and that's what I'm here to teach you. You just need 15 minutes to 30 minutes. I'm usually hanging around for 30 minutes. I like the sound of my own voice, so I'll usually do a 30-minute session. But if you come and do 10 to 15 minutes of this, I put it to you that although it's the bare minimum, it is enough to be qualified as a healthy person. If you were to do this every day, and not necessarily here with me, although I like your company, but it doesn't have to be that way. You can just do this in front of your desk at work. You can do it in front of your computer. You can stand up for 5 or 10 minutes in between your gaming sessions and do this session, and then slap yourself on the back, jazz her in the house. And I promise I will not chew your ear off about the disappointment that I have from House of the Dragon. I do graphic design, so if you need work done, I do, and I will do so. I'll check out some of your work, and I'm actually in the market for doing that this week. I was going to speak to a guy tomorrow, so good timing, mate. I'll message you after this. Yeah, House of the Dragon, I tried and I failed. Anyway, let's get busy. All right, I think my sound should be reasonably decent. Jordan is GFX19, I like that. Very good timing. It's like this person read my brain. And good hustle, mate. And Twitter, even better. That's cool, I'll message him. Yes, I liked it as well, mate. I mean, even though they obviously had to go woke, even for Hellraiser, they did it pretty well. You know, it's like I'll take female Pinhead. I'll take the female protagonist. There's been female protagonists in Hellraiser before. I mean, when you open in the ninth circle of hell, it doesn't really matter what gender it is, it's getting lured into this trap. It's all good, bro. I'm all about equality. But yeah, I liked it as well. I thought it was good. I think it has a lot of potential for a million spin-offs, which is the way to go. Anyway, folks, this is what we're doing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'll keep my back straighter with a wider stance. 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm rocking the shino ball. Speaking of pinheads, I'm bald head. I'm rocking my shiny head. See, this is why I usually wear a cap, folks, because the bounce that I get off my head, the light, usually goes weird with the green screen, but my hat's been going weird with the green screen, so I figured at least if I can't be a monk, I can look pretend I'm one. Oh, shaman-esque, right? Yeah, the female pinhead is like, yeah, you're pretty evil. What can I say? That's all it takes to be pinhead. So what I'm doing, folks, is the weight's going to the outside of my feet, like the arches that you have in your feet. Weight goes to the outside, sitting back into your heels. I'm going to take a wide stance because I've got bad back posture. So the wider I stand, the straighter my back is perpendicular to the ground, right? Normally when I stand closer, my back sort of, like, it doesn't roll out like that. It's still neutral, but my back leans forward a little bit. Now that's not a problem until you start doing barbell squats. But we're not doing barbell squats. We're just doing regular squats. But nonetheless, I'm going to try some wide ones anyway. I'll put my functional strength training thingy on my Apple Watch just to give me some feedback from my heart to show you that it's going up. And folks, you don't have to go for broke. You can go 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, or even better, whatever cadence you can figure that works for you. Take a load off, breathe, think about what you're going to do after this, what reward you can give yourself for doing the bare minimum, but as I said, the bare minimum of quality exercise, because all the stuff that we're doing in here today is really all you really have to do. That with a bit of walking, folks, and the old squat, and that's all it takes to be healthy. Now, what you've got to slap out of your mind is that healthy isn't looking like some roided up influencer bimbo or himbo online, right? All those people are natty, they're not. They're juicing, you know what I mean? And it takes one to know one. I've used peptides before, heaps of them in the last sort of 5 or 6 years. And although you still have to train and you have to eat properly, it does chisel your looks, so to speak. It makes you able to gain lean muscle mass whilst reducing body fat. So, I mean, it's like the last 10%, really, but nonetheless, it does make a big difference, and you can totally tell if people are using them. What we're trying to do, though, is just to pump. Hey, 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 Ben, good to see you in the house. What we're trying to do is pump blood through your body, folks. Your body is a set of filters. Very simple, but very efficient, which is what makes it not so simple. Extremely efficient, and you have to blast water through them, clean them out, deoxidize them, and increase the blood pressure through your body, reduce it. Sinusoidal, rise and fall. It's like going to sleep and waking back up. Now, the wider I stand, I'm going to try and do some properly. I'll form stickler myself. Ah, that's when I can feel it opening up, unlocking my hips at that bottom place, feeling that weight in the bottom of my glute, and only going down to parallel. So your femur, this big bone in your upper body, in your upper leg, certainly not your upper body, and if it is, call the hospital. What you want to do, folks, is go down so that femur is parallel to the ground and not past parallel. So you can go past parallel like that, but look at my back, it rounds out because I've got terrible flexibility. So if you've got better flexibility, by all means, go it. But as you can see, my heart rate's up to 90, so that's 30 basis points or 30, excuse me, beats per minute further up than it normally is. Take a bit of a break, shake out my legs a bit. Like I said, don't go for broke, folks. You're competing against yourself and your performance yesterday. We're not competing against LeBron James or Laura Neva, such an awesome surfer. If you're following surfer, she's my favorite female athlete, although a big fan of Serena Williams, and I'd go as far to say Serena Williams and Kelly Slater are my two favorite athletes of all time. They're unrivaled. King Kelly, 11-time world champion. I mean, it's hard to beat that in any sport, really. Somebody like, what's his name? Lewis Hamilton, I guess, is a pretty good athlete. And I consider racing to be a serious sport. Like anything that you're doing faster than what a human can normally do, you get that terror sweat. Lewis Hamilton's probably up there as well. And if you haven't seen the movie, King Richard, about the Serena and Venus Williams, it's a brilliant movie. It's what's better than a nonfiction story? It's just so crazy to see where they came from and what they did to become, like I said, Serena Williams, arguably in the top three best athlete, not best female athletes, best athletes of all time. Because people are like, Tom Brady or whatever. And maybe I don't know enough about football, but it's just like the competition level between one sport that one country plays and a sport that the entire world plays, I say, is slightly more competitive than American football. But not saying the athleticism in American football isn't insane. It really is, and I do like watching it as well. But it's not as cool as tennis. Tennis is boxing that can last 5 hours where you can't punch the other person in the face. Makes no sense to a thug like me, folks. What can I say? 5 hours of mind games without getting over there and bang. Working the inside, going low, going high. Imagine somebody like Federer. He needs a good punch in the throat before he ends up crying when you beat him. I'll do a few more squats. Then I'm going to do some push-ups tonight. Do them off your knees, folks. I'm going to do strict push-ups just to try and do a few, get my upper body pumping, because I'm going to be starting doing more chin-ups this week as well once I get my outside set up. But I got lost in car electronics today in the garage and lost in some AC/DC for those about to rock. It was awesome. The start of that song, every time I hear it, I get goosebumps. And I've been listening to it since I was like 7 years old. And it still comes on. And I'm like, yeah, give me a beer. Those were the days. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm going to do 10 more and then I'm going to do some push-ups. And we'll call it quits. Hope you guys had a good weekend. I had a great weekend. Second day in, like I said, just building the Beetle. That's going well. Ordering new parts, push rods, push rod tubes, cylinders, cylinder head, pistons. Going some machine work done. It's going to be good. Yes, for those about to rock, fire! We salute you. I was reading about them. So, the Phil, what is his name? Phil Rudd or something? Like the drummer, I think he is. He's like tried to get someone killed and was pulled up on methamphetamine charges. Brian Johnson, the lead singer, has dementia, I think. Malcolm Young died in 2017. And hey, what I read as well, Angus Young's a teetotaler. So even though he smokes, like, I think when they did that, what was it, Black Ice or something, they had their album, there was like a tally on how many cigarettes they smoked for recording the whole album. It was like, you know, a pallet load or something. It was insane. But hey, last man standing doesn't drink and never has. Angus Young has never drunk. So I think that's pretty cool. I like reading stuff about that. It makes me feel better as a teetotaler now. Not only mentally better as I already do, but just cool to see that people figured out the other way, you know, the other route without being drawn in and suckered in. Like, for me, alcohol was always about tolerating social environments because I'm such an introvert. So after a while, you're getting drunk all the time and you get pick up a habit of it because you have to do it to be around people. Now, I'm not saying, you know, I don't drink now, it doesn't mean I don't hang out with people, but it just means I limit the time. When I start wigging out, then, you know, jump the back fence, which is the classic Gordo Phantom move. 10 more, let's do some push-ups. 1, 2, I'm gonna straighten my back and try better with some sumo stance. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, folks, even if you just do what we just did then, you will grease a groove, to use the term that Ben uses, and after a while, even without thinking about it, you'll get to that unconscious competence phase where you'll be doing it properly and you won't even be thinking about it. So that's where we're getting to. You will dig it. I will switch down to the crutch cam. Yeah, speaking of, man, cold peppermint loose leaf tea. I keep in massive jars in my fridge. It's the ultimate thing to do because I don't drink anything with sugar in it. So folks, I'll get rid of that. That looks very weird. You know what a push-up is. You've seen it all before. Heard it on the radio. Seen it on the TV show. A to the K, A to the motherfucking Z. I'll probably get the record company coming after me. You violated Cypress Hill's tune. So anyway, if you can't do a push-up, folks, do them off your knees like this. You don't have to be able to do them strictly. But as I said, this is a push-up because look, folks, I'm pushing myself up off the ground. I'm pumping blood through my shoulders. And if you start getting fatigued, if you are doing normal push-ups, then you can rock out a few of these bad boys and you'll soon see that there is actually not that much difference between that and a push-up. That's a great way to warm up as well, folks. So just same deal. Spread your fingers. By spreading your fingers, you're telling your brain that you're going to do something that involves coordination. It's the same reason why you spread your toes and really grip with your toes. You're sending a signal to your brain, and it's like, I've got to coordinate some stuff, so get as many muscles involved as possible. And when you're breathing, adjust your hands maybe, see what feels the most comfortable on your shoulders. And just as a proof of concept, actually, I'm just going to rep out doing push-ups from my knees. And you guys should try it as well. That's it. Cypress Hills crutch cam PM. Give it a whirl, folks. So if you've doing strict push-ups, and that's all well and good, but doing push-ups off your knees will also sort of unlock some areas of the push-up that will help you for your strict push-up as well, all right? And like I said, you might want to focus more on your hands position or your finger spread. So when you're doing it, you might want to, like I said, sort of walk your... So instead of being at a right angle, you sort of push your hips forward, so you're taking on a little bit more of the load, so you'll feel your core tighten up. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. I feel the burn in that for sure. It's a different type of burn. You feel it more in your chest. When you're doing a strict push-up, it takes a lot of your chest off because of the core stability that you have. Because you don't get so much core stability, when you're doing them off your knees, you'll find you'll be pressing more with your tricep and your shoulders. So, yeah, shoulders and chest. So it's not a bad variation. And I'll chill for a minute. Let the blood flow back in. Very happy with my gauges. So I've got just the same gauges that I would normally use in the plane that I fly mostly, which is a PA-28 Piper Warrior, or Piper Apache, sorry. So cylinder head temperature to see basically where the spark occurs at the top of the piston stroke is the part that gets hotter, and that's why when you hear of blown head gaskets, that's the gasket that's between the cylinder head and the cylinder itself. So the hotter the cylinder head gets, it's a good warning that you're starting to sort of push the limits of the engine. And then I have oil pressure, oil temperature, which are good metrics. If oil pressure shoots up, something's about to blow. If it goes too low, obviously you're not getting enough oil pressure to lubricate the engine and it's about to start heating up, expanding and exploding. And the last one is oil temperature. So when oil gets too hot, it loses its viscosity and stops lubricating. Its properties as lubricating no longer work. So cylinder head, oil pressure, oil temperature are good gauges. And to have, so even though you've got an alternator and a battery, you can see that you're drawing, or you know, it's about 12 volts in the battery, 13 to 14 when the alternator's running. So you can see if the alternator's not working, and you can see if it's just draining the battery if it starts dropping below 12 volts. So they're all pretty good to have on an air-cooled car. All right, 2 minutes, whoopsie. So I'll do a few push-ups, strict ones. Digging in your toes, looking up, clenching your butt. yeah, and all glitz and glamour here in Start Building Me Studios. I heard this rattling in my air conditioner. I was like, what's that rattling? And I looked up and sort of tapped it, and a cockroach flew into my face that was in the air conditioner. I was like, rah! Folks, who needs Hollywood when you got all the glitz and glamour right here? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let German volume train it out. Actually, I've got to twat that thing. Bear with me. Got him. He won't be sleeping tonight because he's dead. Dave's roach ranch sure is vile. There's not that many in here. It's funny because I, like, most of my diet is made up, like the dogs get fed outside and my diet is protein formula basically, so there's no crumbs or anything in this house. And if I eat something, I'll go out and get like some tacos or a burrito up the road or a kebab. Like, I don't make anything here because my, you know, isotonic diet of just protein formula and banana is makes me feel like $1 million, so I don't really bother from it. Everything else is just tea, fruit tea, and black coffee at the same time every day. So I'm not sure exactly what their sustenance is. Maybe my dead skin, the dead skin mask. Oh, he's twitching, he's struggling. I'll have to pay him a visit on the way after the stream, folks. Make sure he's got his family well and truly here as well. Gas them all. All right, I'm gonna do some more. Bats creeping in through the roof lighting holes. Wow, like big bats, or are they just like, actually, all bats are pretty big, eh? There's like not many of those tiny little bats. We have heaps of fruit bats in Sydney as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 18 minutes. Take another minute. Yeah, he's struggling. He's struggling. Hard to climb the wall when you're missing half your legs that got smashed off by a bit of heavy duty foam. Dun, 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 dun. I seen big flying. Yeah, I bet. My cousin's terrified of them. My cousin Pap, he got a whole bunch of tattoos on his arm. It's like my 26-year-old cousin. He's like one of my best mates. And he was coming back from a night at the pub and there were bats in the tree above him. And it rustled a drop of water and it fell on him, on his tattoo that was fresh. And he's sure that he had like, you know, what is it, rabies or something? So he went and he was like committed and went and got all the 7 shots because he was paranoid. He's like a pretty big hypochondriac. Like, oh, it makes sense. Like, both of his parents died, you know? So he's like, it makes sense that he's got a complex about it. But, yeah, 7 shots, I think, in the stomach or something they give you for rabies. You know, I probably would have had one on the barbecue and eaten it, not gotten a shot, but that's Dirty Dave Gordo for you. Anyway, do some more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I didn't go into my cold plunge today. I pussied out. Feel quite ashamed. I was like, I'll do it after now, but no, I will not be doing it after now. I'm gonna go for a cruise in the Beetle with my nice red voltage gauge and bask in my glory there, folks. Hope you got something decent planned. Andor, I think, is coming out as well. Lysavirus. Now, well, he got 7 shots. Yeah, maybe for the Lysavirus, I don't know. He got rabies. The rabies shots, because I went to the doctor with him for like 2 of the times or 3 of the times. He had to get them on all separate days. Yeah, but I mean, I don't particularly like them. If I had a property and a 12-gauge shotgun and some duck shot, I have a feeling I'd be blasting them out of the sky, but... Oh, should I say that out loud? Sorry, Peter. No, I wouldn't. That would be illegal. I think, are they, yeah, I think they're native. Aussie version of rabies. Ah, by bats, right. Well, ding. Give it another few seconds. Spread your fingers, tense a butt. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Bust out a few more sets, and then I'm gonna go for a cruise. Maybe get some tacos. The power of suggestion. And my lighting setting. Looks alright in here, it looks alright outside, so that should be okay as well. Don't have to buy anything for the time being, which is good. Can just build my engine. Gonna do 10 more and call it quits, and that'll be 30 minutes anyway. Perfect. Speaking of Aussie version, I was listening to what was the Jake E. Lee album with Never on it and Secret Loser Jazz? The Ultimate Sin? The Original Sin? The Ultimate Sin, I think. I was listening to that the other day. That's such a good album. Jake E. Lee, I think I would have to say he was my favorite Aussie guitarist. All this Zach Wilde crap. Yeah, The Ultimate Sin. And that, I read in somewhere that it's Sharon, you know, the demoness woman on the front, that's supposed to be Sharon Osbourne. Ultimate Sin, yeah, man. Never. When you lent me that album, man, I thrashed that. It's such a good album. Anyway, Yes, Never is awesome. That solo is easy. Check it out, Ben. Never, Ozzy Osbourne, Never, and listen to the solo. It's like the 80s slapping you in the face. It's amazing. Anyway, 10 more and let's call it quits. Spread the fingers, tense in the butt, look up and breathe. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Anyway, I'll be on the wire. Catch you later, folks. I gotta go and finish that cockroach off. It's doing my head in just like my shiny head normally does in this video. Have a good night.